Now, true crime is like everyone's favorite new soap opera, huh? Good morning, I'm Rock 107's Prospector. It's not enough to watch people get murdered on TV dramas. Now we got to see the real ones, too. And we're so hooked on true crime that the CW is airing a documentary on Northeast PA bad guy Hugo Solinsky. The CW, the network that usually gives you teen vampires and superheroes, is now bringing you serial killers. Hugo Solinsky, remember this guy? This guy was like the yard sale of crime. I mean, the dude had bodies buried all over his backyard. He's like, oh, you got some extra skeletons? Toss them in the garden. No one's even going to notice. And now the CW is like, yeah, let's make that our next primetime feature. How's that for family-friendly programming? Right after Riverdale, coming up next, a double murderer who couldn't even keep his backyard tidy. And this guy didn't just kill people. No. He had to make it interesting. There were five bodies in his backyard. Five. You know how hard it is to keep a backyard looking good with just one body buried under it? This guy's got five. I can't even keep a houseplant alive, and he's got a human compost pile going on. Five bodies. At some point, you're not even a murderer anymore. You're just running a cemetery. Hugo Solinsky, the world's worst landscaper right here in Northeast PA. And this guy beat a murder rap on two of them. Two murder charges. Beat it. Yeah. I mean, how do you explain that? Oh, yeah, those two drug dealers, they were found dead in my yard. I didn't kill them. I just misplaced their bodies. It's like a lost and found for gangster. And the jury's like, oh, yeah, that sounds reasonable. I'm sorry, but if you've got any dead bodies in your yard, I don't think you get a free pass. That's not a thing. There's no well. He only buried them. He's an okay guy. But don't worry, his luck ran out because, surprise, they found other bodies in his backyard. And at that point, you got to wonder, how much real estate does this guy have? Is his backyard a subdivision for corpses? Were these people buying plots? Oh, yeah, we got plots right next to the burn pit. Great location. Quiet neighbors. You'll never hear them. Solinsky's sitting there in jail now, you know, after the daring escape from Luzerne County's lockup years back. He's staring down life without parole. Never going to get out. But you know what's wild? Even with all the dead bodies and the crime, we're all going to tune in. We can't help it. We're addicted to Hugo. Remember, this cat had groupies while he was on the run. Groupies for a killer. This guy's like a train wreck. You can't stop watching. And now, thanks to the CW, we get to watch it all unfold right after a new episode of Superman. The Mall Walk. All right, nowadays the E in the E Street Band stands for insurer. The New York Giants got their first win yesterday. For those of you keeping track, that means six more seals must be open before the apocalypse can happen.
Prospector ruins everything, even the news. Tune in tomorrow for Prospector's Briefs on Rock 107.
Never underestimate a good cover song. Good morning, it's Prospector Show on Rock 107. I'm Prospector. For some bands, those covers are just as popular as their originals. Even more so, there are bands that have made their career of covers, like Quiet Riot. Without the cover of Slade, come on, feel the noise. We're probably not talking about Quiet Riot, right? Loudwire.com, a great website, made a list of best covers of by 50 of rock's biggest bands. So highlights, along with the original artists. They're number one, and I love this song. I don't know if it's my number one cover, but I love it. AC/DC's version of Baby Please Don't Go, the old Joe Williams Washboard Blues Singers thing.
Well, I'll be a doll. Well, I'll be a doll. Well, I'll be a doll if you went out of hell.
Just love the guitar in that version. It's just so cool there. Aerosmith's Come Together ranked highly. Def Leppard's Rock On from David Essex. I like the original one on that one better. And a guy who I love, Prince, one of his covers showing up. Not him doing a cover, another band covering Prince. And I'm like, Prince and Zeppelin are bands I'm like, you just don't mess with. Hendrix is like that too. I'm like, I don't know about covering them, but this one I like.
She took me to a castle and I just couldn't believe my
eyes. Yeah, Foo Fighters.
She had so many devices.
Doing Darlin' Nikki by Prince.
Money goodbye. She said, sign your name on the dotted line. Nikki has started to grind.
I thought that was just an amazing version of that song. Now, I talked about Zeppelin. Godsmack does Good Times, Bad Times. It's okay. Hailstorm Still of the Night from Whitesnake is up there. And this one, which Loudwire credits to Kiss. And I know the albums were Kiss and then the name of the solo guys. But this is an Ace Frehley song. It's from his solo album when he was in Kiss. The old Hello song, New York Groove.
Here I am.
I would argue argue that might be a top five cover for me. I just think that's just such a great version. Marilyn Manson, Sweet Dreams from the Eurythmics. Nickelback, Sad But True by Metallica in that top 20 as well. And then two songs that I think really helped launch these bands' careers. And there were bands that didn't get stuck as only being known as cover bands. Red Hot Chili Peppers with their cover of Stevie Wonder's Higher Ground. Not even the first cover the Peppers did. They had covered Bob Dylan. They had covered Sly and the Family Stone and a bunch of other bands, the Meters and all that. But that was the one that kind of put them on the map. And the song that introduced most of us to Van Halen.
Girl, you really got me now. You got me started.
Yeah, You Really Got Me by the Kinks. So many great covers. The rest are listed on my Facebook page. We go to www.facebook.com/angryprospector. You can find them there. Modern-day criminals are ruining our day-to-day lives. Good morning, I'm Rock 107's Prospector. Because of those shoplifter types, a lot of stuff is locked up at the stores. You can't even get at it without having to ask a store employee to open the cases.
And now thoughts from the teeth whitener locked behind plexiglass at Target.
Man, I hate being in mouthwash prison. I give people a white smile. Why am I stuck in the green mile? I don't get it. People keep stealing us, but we get punished. As my cellmate Speedstick put it, the whole thing stinks. I mean, come on. Why not lock up the ramen? It's always getting in hot water. Uh-oh, somebody started a riot in the makeup block. Maybe it's Maybelline. When will someone bust me out?
Hey, can you open this one for me?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Hey, dude, get me out of here. Oh, wait, he's in a WrestleMania tank top. He doesn't care about his teeth.
Those were thoughts from the teeth whitener locked behind plexiglass at Target.
Repeat, please. Your last message was not clear.
Encouraging all to detach from technology and go enjoy your life in the real world. Sent from his iPhone. Prospector.
I'm not while driving.
Rock 107.
It's time to have a little fun on the phones. Good morning. I'm Rock 107's Prospector. And with Halloween coming up, you know the costume places are going to start getting busy. They're going to be getting phone calls. And they're going to try and help people. I thought it'd be fun to call and try to get an inappropriate costume to be like a sexy costume. You know what I mean? So the costume itself is fine until I want to make it sexy. And now it's inappropriate. And I'm going to be using my silly character, Klaus, to do it. It's time for another Prospector prank call on Rock 107. Yes, hello. Hello. Yeah, I'm calling for a costume. Do you have them?
Yeah, we have all types of costumes.
Okay. My name is Klaus. Who am I speaking to?
Oh, it's Andy.
Andy, okay. So this year I want to put together a costume, and I need suggestions. How to assemble, how to do the perfect sexy costume. I'm so excited. You have a moment to help, please?
Yeah, I look forward
to your suggestions. Okay, are you ready?
Yeah, let's go.
Are you ready? Okay, so the first costume I want to be sexy 911 operator. Like the 911, what's your emergency, baby? Oh, you know, you like that?
I don't know if they have an exact uniform for that costume that you want. Maybe a headset or something, but I don't think that's going to make you look sexy because with the operator.
Well, why do you say that?
Oh, it's not really a job to be sexy for when people are in distress calling.
Oh, okay. Let me give you another one. This one I want to be very sexy. Human resources director for a big company. So if somebody comes in, they'd be harassed. I'm like, they come to me and I give them the report and I'm so sexy. They get distracted. What do you think of that one, making me something sexy?
Yeah, I don't think that's quite appropriate.
Why do you say that?
You're helping people. I don't think you're going to be trying to be sexy.
It's always good to be sexy, right? Okay. I give you one more, another one. Maybe I could be, let's say, sexy high school counselor. Like a student comes in, they get the FAFSA form, and I'm like, hey, yeah. They'd be like, you're so hot, everybody wants to come see me for the counseling and say hello.
Oh, I think that's very inappropriate for a high school.
What's so inappropriate?
You're dealing with a bunch of kids. You don't want to be sexy for kids. That's gross.
All right. We don't do the kids, right? We don't do that. How about I say this? How about I want to be a sexy gynecologist? Yeah, now that's very sexy, right? Very sexy.
Oh, gynecologist, huh? This is a joke, right?
Well, why are you laughing so hard like it's a joke? You've not helped me at all. I want to be the sexy gynecologist.
Oh, this has got to be a joke. How would this even work?
Because the person comes in and it's a very sexy environment. We put on some music and I'm like, hey, baby, what's happening to you? I talk to them in a way, you know, that say, I'm like, you. Do you have to be ugly to be gynecology exam?
I don't think you're going to be fixed.
I think that's so great. I think it's so great you're getting so much, amusement out of this. I'm trying to be sexy costume. You have nothing for me. Let me get this straight. A sexy infant, that would be out of the question, all right? A sexy infant?
We definitely don't have no sexy infant.
You know what? You know what I'm saying? Look, you help me make a costume. You have something, all right?
Yeah, we have all types of costumes.
We can get a big baby diaper. Not like a baby diaper, but something like carve out the abs for me or something. Oh, look at that baby. It's so hot. Do you have anything like that?
Who is this? You got to be kidding me right now.
My name is Klaus. Klaus. I'm trying to be sexy for Halloween. You're not even helping me. You're not helping me.
You got to be kidding me right now. This is not real, right?
Actually, it's not real. You're on Rock 107 right now, man. This is a Prospector prank call. A Prospector.
Oh, so I'm on the radio right now?
Yeah, man, it's not real. I'm not Klaus. I'm not trying to be a sexy gynecologist. You're okay, man. You're off the hook.
Yeah, you got me going. Man, thinking, what is up with this guy?
Why don't you want to help me be sexy for Halloween? Come on.
Oh, my God. It has to be a joke. I'm just thinking, what is the matter with this guy?
Life's pretty tough right now. There's plenty of bad news, but it's not all bad. It's time for the brighter side of Prospector on Rock 107.
Atrium Health owns a bunch of hospitals in North Carolina and Georgia, and they've just announced they're forgiving more than 11,000 people's old medical debt, which is great news. But there may be a reason they're looking to look like good guys. NBC News did a story this month on how the company was aggressively pursuing that debt, even putting liens on people's homes, so they got publicly shamed for it, and it looks like it worked.
Thanks. We needed that. The brighter side of Prospector on Rock 107.
You may have gotten turned around due to road closures for this. Good morning. I'm Rock 107's Prospector. I went for a bike ride Sunday morning and got turned around twice because the Electric City had a very special visitor. Yeah, get this. Ukrainian President Zelensky comes all the way to Scranton, Pennsylvania. Scranton! To thank the workers at the ammunition plant. I mean, look, I grew up in Scranton. I live in Scranton. I love Scranton. Don't get me wrong, but really? Of all places in the world, he's like, you know where I gotta go? Scranton. He walks in there, and I'm picturing the workers like, wait. So who's here? Zelensky? The president of the Ukraine? Or should we clean up or something? We got half-eaten hoagies and bowling shoes lying around somewhere. And Zelensky's being all serious, walks in, and he's like, I hear there's 400 people working here. Probably looking around like, 400, where are they hiding? Because you know when important people show up, everybody suddenly disappears. Oh, I got to run to the supply room for a couple hours. But there's President Zelensky of the Ukraine, and he's like, 400 people have saved millions of Ukrainians. It's got to feel a little weird, right? You're just a guy doing a gig, making artillery shells in Scranton, and you're like, oh yeah, I make the big boom booms. I didn't realize I was saving the world over here. Imagine being one of those workers. Hey, Bob, what do you do today? I just made some 155-millimeter artillery shells. No big deal. Might have saved a couple hundred thousand people. Probably going to go grab a pizza later. And Scranton's mayor's there, and she's all proud. This is a poignant moment. Oh, slow down there, Mayor Cognetti. I got to get out my big book of words. Poignant? That's a fancy word for Scranton, isn't it? When I think of Scranton, I don't think of poignant. I think of potholes and snow shovels that break halfway through a storm. But you know what? Hey, poignant moment, sure. And then the media, they couldn't even get in. Even the media wasn't allowed inside. I could see the press out there stuck outside. So we're just going to wait here by this barbed wire fence, maybe get a coffee. I mean, the Scranton Army Ammunition Plant, I bet the big guys like ABC and AP were thinking they'd be covering something glamorous, Hollywood red carpet, something like that. Instead, they're here in Northeast PA, Scranton, waiting for a glimpse of Zelensky through like a barbed wire fence, 100 feet of grass, and dirty glass windows that probably haven't been washed since Carter was president. What's going on in there? What's happening? But you know what? Props to Scranton. Finally on the world stage for something other than The Office.
Let's- ladies and gentlemen, grab the kids, call your neighbors, and gather around the radio.
It's now time to announce the winner of Prospector's Jam Bag of the Day, as decided by you at rock107.com.
We uncover the most baffling, ridiculous, pathetic, cockeyed, laughable, preposterous blunders in the world of misdeeds. Nominee number one.
If you're a burglar, you don't have to just figure out how to get inside. You also need to know how you're going to get out. And it isn't always as straightforward as you might think. A 33-year-old man broke into a luxury Corvette in a parking garage on Miami last week, but he couldn't start the car or get out. Yeah, he couldn't get out. That model has a security feature where none of the electronic components will function if you don't have the key. That includes the doors, although there is a manual release under the seat the guy didn't know about. The owner got back to his car and was startled to see the burglar stuck inside. He started filming with his camera on his phone and asked him what he was doing. The burglar asked the man if he could go help him out. The owner said, "No, we're calling the cops." That's when the guy inside the car said, "For what?" Police came by and arrested the guy. He's facing one count of burglary of an unoccupied conveyance. His bond was set at $2,500.
Nominee number two.
What is it, week three of the fantasy football season? Hopefully no one in your league is taking things too seriously, especially not to the point where they're making international threats. A 25-year-old man from Philadelphia named Matthew Gabriel pleaded guilty to two counts of interstate and foreign threats after he made a false tip to police in the United States and overseas, claiming his fantasy football rival was a threat. It all started last year when the two men had some kind of fantasy football argument. It's unclear if it was heated banter that got out of hand or if they were hotly debating a waiver pickup or something. Matthew knew the other guy was studying abroad in Norway, so he called authorities there and made an anonymous tip that his rival was planning a mass shooting at a concert and a department store. Norway says they spent 900 man hours investigating the case before they realized it was a hoax. During that month-long investigation, Matthew did it again. This time he emailed another fictitious threat to the University of Iowa here in the USA. In an account under another name, he claimed the same fantasy football group member was threatening to blow up the school. Naturally, the FBI was brought in to investigate, and Matthew was eventually charged.
And the winner is...
the man who falsely reported that his fantasy football rival planned to shoot up a concert in Norway and blow up the University of Iowa. You are the Yam Bag of the Day, and we'll move on to Friday's Yam Bag of the Week competition. Keep it here for all the nominees for Prospector's Yam Bag of the Day, weekday mornings on Rock 107. Thanks for listening to Prospector's Prime Cuts Podcast. Be sure to catch us live weekdays from 5:30 to 10 a.m. on Rock 107 or online at rock107.com or the Rock 107 app, a free download for your Android or iPhone. Subscribe to the podcast on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Stitcher Radio, or wherever you get your podcasts so you never miss Prospector's Prime Cuts.